Hi everyone. Okay, so you've managed to find your way into the library databases, and now we want to actually run a search. So I've pre-populated this here. So let's just say I wanted to do a search for Star Trek. What we're going to see here is an awful lot of resources. So what I would suggest you would do if you were interested, this is where you put your second angle in. So if you wanted to type in Star Trek and you're interested in gender roles, that's even already popping up. We hit search. And you can see we've got 9. So this is a much smaller field to be able to look for. And that suggests actually that there probably is a good amount of room if you were interested in studying gender roles in Star Trek. 9 articles isn't a lot. And so that gives us some ground a good idea that there is actually what we call, right, a research problem. We don't know a whole lot about gender in Star Trek. 9 articles really isn't a lot. However, so let's say we want to do a search, right? We're interested in Star Trek and gender roles, and we're like, okay, obviously I want to, well, based on it here, click on this thing. It says a parody of Star Wars, Star Trek. Well, it's got some stuff about gender roles, so maybe we want to take a look at this, but I'm thinking from the title, if we're really interested in this, that it's not going to get us what we need. We can also tell that it's German here from this title, so I'm thinking this probably isn't a great source. But this next one here, Gender, Star Trek's Next Generation, if we click on that, we can then read the abstract. This looks like a little bit more up our alley, and then we could click on here, the PDF full text, and it brings up the article. We can tell it's a peer-reviewed journal article because it's got some of that page formatting. It says Journal of Gender Studies, so that's an academic journal. The volume, page number, and year, we can see how it's formatted. And if we scroll all the way to the end, we'll see a list of references. I'm a little surprised, to be honest, that it's this short, but it is a short essay. So at least it would give us a piece of the puzzle in terms of what it is we want to look at. So if we back up to our main list here, this one here published a little bit more, well, slightly recently. This is another thing. If we could do a look for Star Trek, and we're noticing here that all of these are pretty old articles, that gives us also more of an avenue to study Star Trek and gender roles, because most of what we're seeing here is at least a decade, if not closer to 2 decades old. So again, we go to PDF full text, and we can take a look at it. We can see it's got some of those, right? We can tell that it's a journal article because it's got the journal name up here, right? Page formatting. We know it's definitely, we hang on here, right? It's 20 pages long. So this is, right, a decent sized article. And we see a long, actually that's still pretty short. Again, I'm pretty surprised. I have to admit, I'm a little bit baffled that in a 20 page article, they don't have more sources. So again, this is just to point out, just because it's published doesn't necessarily mean it's the be all and end all, but it's a peer reviewed journal article. Whether or not they've got solid resources or not, or as much research as I think they ought to have, doesn't mean that it's not a peer reviewed journal article, right? So it's definitely a peer reviewed journal article. So we see here, though, again, a couple of things come up. We'll come back to these actually on ways to rule out. So let's say we wanted to look at humor and gender. Again, this is a German article. We wouldn't necessarily want it because it's in German. If you can read German, okay, cool. I can't, so this would mean it's off limits for me. However, actually, let's just clear this out. And If we take a look at this first result that came up when it was just Star Trek, queer futurity in Star Trek. However, this one is super new, August 2020, really new journal articles. You usually can't get that PDF full text because there's some kind of embargo on it. It's really silly. It goes back to the publishing industry. We don't need to worry about why, but if we want to get a really super new article, we're going to have to ask for it through interlibrary loan. So if you click on interlibrary loan, what it's going to ask you to do, and it's going to pre-populate here because I've been here before, but you want to type in your username, so all the stuff that comes before the @ in your email, and what your current BSU password is. You click on log on, right? ILL is interlibrary loan, and it's got all of this. It'll pre-populate all of this for you. You click on submit request, and then it will send you, you'll get an email from the Interlibrary Loan office telling you when it is popped, when it's popped up in their queue. And then what you'll do is you go on to here, right, because this is a new request. You'll go into electronically received articles and it will show up here, right? I haven't asked for it and it hasn't been sent, so there's nothing listed here. So that's how you request something from Interlibrary Loan, which is really easy. So if we go back in here, right, and again, we can take a look at different articles that are popping up. So if there isn't a PDF in the particular databases we're looking for, but it knows that it can get you a full text PDF in a different database, it'll have that here, Full Text Finder. So if we click on Full Text Finder, we'll want to keep this open because we're going to need this information in a minute. And it says we can find this journal in the Wiley Online Library. So we click on that, it's going to give us another window. So it's taken us to the Journal of Popular Culture, but when it does this, it takes you to the main page of that journal. So we want to go back to that window. I've clicked on the window. Okay, we want volume 52, issue 6, so 2019, right? So we'll click on this button here, 2019, volume 52, we'll click on that, and we want issue 6, that'll bring it up, and we want to scroll down until we find our article, and keep looking, 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 here we are, Star Trek, click on PDF. And then we're in, right? So those are a couple of things. So this is how you can find, first of all, the PDF, right? Full text PDFs, and a couple of ways. I'm gonna close these windows out. A couple of things just to find avenues that show you how to find resources that don't have that immediate PDF. Something that you also might want to do. So let's say we're doing, and there are a couple of, I'm going to close this window too. Okay, so let's say we're doing our searches, right? We've told it to look only for peer-reviewed articles, but we see right here, right, this says review. So this is a new thing that EBSCO has started doing. If you're looking in a different database, you want to remember, right, Academic Search Premier and Common Mass Media run by EBSCO. So they've got this handy little visual tag. So this says review. So we can also see here, it says 3 pages, right? That's a pretty good signal that whatever this is, it's not full on academic research. And it says review. So that's telling us that it is a review. So if we click on the PDF full text right here, we'll see, right, Star Trek and American Television. This is a review of a book published by Roberta Pearson and Mary Messenger Davies. And so it gives us the information about the book. So if you read the review and you think it's interesting, then you want to go in and request the book. So you could actually do that by going into the library, going under services, and then looking for interlibrary loan. Again, if you're not sure how to ask for a book under interlibrary loan, you can always use a chat window off the main page from the library to ask a librarian on advice about how to do that. So if you read this and you think it looks cool, you have to get the book. Citing the review is no good because this is not peer-reviewed academic research. However, because this review of Star Trek and American Television is published in a peer-reviewed journal, it will show up when you click that filter for peer-reviewed results. So that's one of the things that you want to keep in mind when you're looking for sources is that just because it says it's just because it's been published in a peer-reviewed journal doesn't mean it is actually peer-reviewed journal research. Something else. So even though we've asked it to only limit itself to peer-reviewed journal research, which you would think would mean only academic journals, sometimes stuff sort of sneaks through. So we see here, for instance, right, this article. Obviously, this is a different search term, so I've brought up a couple of windows just to streamline what I'm finding for you guys. And so right here, we've got a periodical, right? So that tells you it's not peer-reviewed journal research because it would say academic journal. But if we pull up the PDF, we see here, right, 4 pages, this is not going to be a serious academic journal article. So it might have interesting information. If I were highlighting domesticity, this would be a pretty cool article. But again, it's not terribly long. It's got some interesting information, but it's not peer-reviewed journal articles. Maybe we want to use this for some color, maybe in our introduction, so we could keep it. But it's not something we're going to use in our literature review, right? It's a periodical. It's not full-on peer-reviewed academic research. Okay, so the last thing we want to keep in mind that you might see, again, this is a different topic. This is about Buffy the Vampire Slayer. You'll see this here. So it says conference. Well, if it's a conference, right, this is not our academic journal. So technically, it's probably been peer reviewed. Like somebody on a conference review committee took a look at it and said, yeah, this sounds cool. Let's schedule it. But this is not published peer reviewed journal article research. So if it says conference and it's got these little icons here of people at a conference, this isn't something we want. Right, so our other cue is, we pull up the PDF on it. It's just taken a second to think through that. You'll see rough draft, not for citation. It even says that right at the top. So that's a little bit surprising. Right, but we see here there's no name, right? There's no Journal of Cinema Studies, nothing of that, right? And so we've got the introduction. Typically, these are often double-spaced, just like you would double-space your own papers. This one is single-spaced, so it might look like it's double, it might look like it's page set, but this is not a peer-reviewed journal article. But that doesn't mean we can't look for information in it. So if we go down to the end bibliography, what we're going to see here is there are citations of peer-reviewed academic research. So we've got, right, the Online International Journal of Buffy Studies. I did not know there was such a thing, my goodness. We've got something called Poroi, whatever that is. That definitely sounds fancy. We've got some books, right? And these are peer-reviewed academic research. So you could go ahead and cite these. So those are just a couple of things that you want to keep in mind, again, when you're looking for academic research. So I've flipped back to a different page. Right, what we're looking for with academic research, right? This is in Visual Communication Quarterly. That sounds like a journal. We've got a volume, an issue number. It's short for a journal article. This one, 13 pages, but that's definitely enough. This one here, whatever this is, right, it says one page. This is probably just a review, right? No solid academic article is going to have just one page. So just a couple of things to keep in mind while you're doing your searches.